I just felt like something was just finna drop in my hand, like, at any given moment. A girl was finna text me and tell me, yo, dude, in the streets, you feel me? Yeah, I just knew he was up to no good. I just knew he was cheating on me, bro. Like, I just knew. I reached my hand back and I slapped him. Like, I applied pressure. Like, I applied force to it. I'm like, Green, who is this in your phone, bro? Like, not this again. Not this lame stuff again. So, what is up, DD gang? Welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Orion, and thank you for tuning in today. Trust.
I just wanna take you out and show you off. You already know that you the perfect one.
I know I haven't been here in a way. I haven't been posting no videos. I haven't been posting no content. But I've just been taking a breather and taking time. Actually, I haven't even been gone for that long. But I'm finna start trying to be more consistent for y'all. As y'all read from the title, today's video is gonna be something a little different. I actually have always wanted to do story times on my channel, but I never really took the time to just sit down and think about an interesting story time, or like, I just always feel like, oh, nobody gonna really watch it. But at the same time, content is content, and I feel like this is an interesting story to tell. So, and this story is not to bash nobody or like make nobody out to look bad. I'm not even gonna be using nobody's specific name. Only reason I'm talking about this story is because, like I said, I want to do story times on my channel, and also I feel like a lot of girls experience this and go through things like this, so I just want to tell my story because I know y'all gonna be able to relate to it, you feel me? But yeah, I'm not gonna ramble too much. I'm not gonna ramble at all, in fact. And just make sure you like, comment, and subscribe right now, and let's just get straight into this story time. Okay, so first I'm gonna start off jumping into this story time by just giving everybody code names, because like I said, the purpose of me telling stories is not to bash nobody, so I'm not gonna say nobody's actual name. If you feel like this relates to you or the shoe fits, then wear it. But I'm not gonna say nobody's name. So the main character, which is my ex, obviously, we're gonna name him Green, because everything he did was green. And then that's when we're gonna name his homeboy Back End, because I had him on the back end. But we're going to get into that. And then we're going to name. So now that I've already made a name for my ex and his homeboy, now the other two characters are going to be my ex's girlfriends. So this is going to be two of my ex's ex-girlfriends. So basically, these two girls are girls that my ex used to date. So the first girl, which is ex number one, we're going to name her Ace. And she won't be mentioned much in this story. And then ex number two, we're gonna name her Spade. So I hope I'm not confusing y'all, but as I proceed and I start telling the story, y'all gonna get more clarification and the names just gonna start to flow. So just sit back, relax, and let's just start off with the backstory. So me and Green met when I was in high school or whatever. So we met in high school. I used to stay on the north side or whatever, and I'm not gonna say the specific name of the school, but yeah, we met there, and we met in the cafeteria one day, and we just started kicking it off, and we just started vibing, you feel me? We were just talking, and it wasn't nothing like serious. We never made anything serious. We was just always vibing, just talking, and he would give me vibes like he liked me, but he never really like made that official, you feel me? Like, he never really took that step and said, oh, like, he never made it obvious that he liked me, but at the same time I could see from his actions, you know what I'm trying to say? So yeah, that's basically how we met. It wasn't nothing major. We met in the cafeteria one day. I was walking in the cafeteria, then we just basically started talking, you feel me? And I would always see him around and he would always see me around, but we never really spoke or said much to each other, you feel me? But that specific day, we ended up talking and we ended up vibing, and yeah, he was getting close on your girl and trying to push up on me. He was, you feel me? He was trying to apply that pressure. Yeah. So now that y'all basically got clarification on how, where, you feel me, how me and Green met, where we met, now I'm finna give y'all the scenario leading up to me finding out how I was getting played, me finding out how I was getting gaslighted, ain't all of the above. You feel me? So let's just jump straight into that. So I'm going to give y'all the scenarios that was leading up to that and how everything took place. Me and Green had been vibing and talking for a cool month. But like I just said in a previous clip, me and him had never made it official. And he had never, like, took that next step with me. So me and him would always be on and off with our communication. So it was nothing serious. So then, this is how me and his homeboy, which I named him Back End, me and Back End, we started talking. You feel me? So Back End started trying to push up on me as well. And somehow, I think Back End had slid my DMs one day. I'm not sure. But me and him had met and he basically started trying to be more consistent. And like, he started texting me out the blue. Like, and then we would just start FaceTiming and talking and stuff like that. So while Green was being inconsistent, you feel me? Back End, he was calling me, texting me every day, you feel me? He would consistently text me, call me, and just try to make his position very permanent in my life. And just, like, he was trying to show me that he was serious without him even saying it. Even though every time me and Back End would be on the phone, he would always tell me consistently that he see himself being with me, like I'm a girl that he want, he like my vibe and stuff like that. But like I said, me and Green, which is his homeboy, we was kicking it out. So even though we didn't have nothing serious, I didn't want to jump into a relationship with Back End and whole time me and his homeboy cool. Mind you, Back End didn't know, or if he did know, he didn't think me and Green had nothing serious going on, because we didn't. So, but I knew that Green and Back End was homeboys. But like I said, me and Green ain't had nothing serious going on. So I didn't care to be cool with. I didn't think it was nothing wrong with me and Back End being cool and stuff like that. And on top of that, Back End was being more consistent than Green. It wasn't no on and off communication when me and Back End was talk. Back End was really trying to push up on you, girl. Like, every night phone calls, checking up on me, and just being consistent, you feel me? And I actually started to kind of feel Back End, but at the same time, I wasn't really ready for no relationship. You feel me? And another reason why I was even considering Back End is because he never switched up, you feel me? He stayed the same person and gave me the same vibe since day one. Like, 3 months, 4 months straight, phone calls, all of that. You feel me? Checking up, just simple stuff. So it was really starting to become clear to me that, okay, clearly Green don't want nothing serious. So I was starting to basically just let that whole situationship go. And I was actually starting to communicate with Back End more. So now I'm finna tell y'all what happened prior to the scenarios and how me and Green basically got close and made it official again, and how we started back talking. So towards the end of the school year, Green started trying to be more consistent, you feel me? It was no longer no on and off kind of stuff. And one day, just out the blue, I don't even know how he found my Instagram, but he had ended up following me on Instagram. And then I followed him back. But every time we would text, it would just be here and there. It wasn't nothing serious, y'all, at all. So I didn't really think much of it. I literally had let the whole thought of me and him being together just diminish from my mind. But towards the end of the school year, he had started replying to my stories more and just started texting me more and trying to get my attention type of stuff. So after a couple of times of him replying to my stories and like complimenting me and stuff like that, me and him had started FaceTiming and talking, and we became more serious. And basically, in the in-between time of him consistently replying to my stories and basically trying to get my attention and, oh, where you at? You feel me? What you been on? Trying to slide his little way back in and play games. So then, in the in-between time, somehow me and him started kicking it off again, and we started FaceTiming, and this time, it wasn't no inconsistency. Like, we was literally talking for about a cool month straight, and we was actually vibing. So during this period of time, me and Back End communication had fell off, because now me and Green was kind of more serious now. Mind you, I'm knowing I'm knowing Green intentions the whole time. Green got word that me and Beck and was kicking it off, you feel me? So Green tried to stop the show, you feel me? He tried to stop Beck and, but whole time I'm knowing what's going on. So even though I'm still vibing with Green because I actually liked our vibe moves together and I actually liked him as a person, I still kept backing on the back end. I still kept his friend on the back end, you feel me? Like, we were still cool, we were still talking, we were still vibing, but it was just less communication. But back end still knew where his place was, and he still knew what went down. So yeah, at this point in time, me and Green basically locked in now, and me and back end still cool. So now I'm finna tell y'all, before I give y'all the scenarios and the screenshots and the yada yada yada, I'm finna let y'all know the red flags that I ignored. Red flag number one was that he still followed his ex. But mind you, when I found out that he still followed his ex, I didn't really think much about it because at that point in time, me and him didn't have nothing serious going on, so I really didn't care. But thinking back on it, you still follow your ex. So basically, you trying to still keep tabs on her. And then she would always give me this weird look. You feel me? Like she had something to hide. Like whenever I would see her in the hallways, she would always just give me this weird look. But she would always look at me weird. So I knew it was something going on. But I ain't never really just pushed the issue because I knew everything was going to come to the light. Mind you, me and this girl looked nothing alike. So really, I wasn't. Me and her can't both be your type. That was another red flag. So let me just go on, spit out all the other red flags so we can get to the scenarios. The other red flags I ignored was no clarification. He never made it clear that we were together, and he never made it clear or told anybody else that we had something going. He would try to basically keep everything a secret, you know, like keep it low key, like he didn't want nobody to know type stuff. He would be so nonchalant every time we had arguments. Like, I was always the one actually trying to fight for the relationship and put in effort and stuff like that. Even though you came back to me. Like, what? And then I would always have dreams about him cheating, y'all. Dreams. And I would always just get this gut feeling that something was going on. But me being me, I didn't really say too much about it. Because like I said, I decided to just let everything flow. And let everything just go the way that it was meant to go. Which it did. So, let's just get into scenario one. So, me and Green would have these little petty arguments all the time. And every time we would have these arguments, back in would come tell me all the stuff that he would say about me. Like, oh, she weird. Oh, she do too much. Yada, yada, yada. So, whole time, I'm playing my position, but I'm still knowing what's really good. Like, I'm still knowing what's going on. I'm still knowing Green, who he really is. So, I'm like, okay, so this specific time, me and Green had got to this little petty argument, and we wasn't talking for about a week, you feel me? And then I just started getting this little feeling like something was going on. I started barely being able to sleep. Like, whenever I'm talking to a person, it's like everything that goes on, my intuition literally just sucks it up. Like, my mind and my body just, it's like my intuition be on go, like always. And I love that for myself. But, so yeah, this specific time me and him had got into an argument and we wasn't talking, and I just kept getting this gut feeling like something was going on, but I didn't want to press the issue. So he was being his nonchalant self like always, and I decided I'm not finna blow up this dude's phone. So I just let it be what it was gonna be. And I was just so anxious. Like, I just had this feeling of anxiety. Like, I knew something was going on. Like, I knew something just wasn't right. Like, I just felt like something was just finna drop in my hand. Like, at any given moment, a girl was finna text me and tell me, yo, dude, in the streets, you feel me? And lo and behold, so I'm going back and forth in my mind thinking, should I text him? Should I not? Should I just hit Green up and make stuff right? But something just kept, just be still, like, just don't do nothing. So, I finally go to sleep, you feel me? And I wake up at 12 a.m., and I'm just scrolling on my phone. Then all of a sudden, I get this message from this girl that followed me in green, but I barely talk to her. We just mutuals. We just cool. She replies to my stories from time to time, and I reply to her stories from time to time. But she follows green, and she was also in green close friends, so she could see everything that he was doing, everything that was going on. She could see the stuff I couldn't see, because whenever me and green would get into arguments, we would unfollow each other. So basically, she knew a lot of stuff that I didn't even know. So I get a message. 12:07 in the morning. I'm like, here we go. Like, I just had this, my heart just dropped. I just had this feeling. Like, y'all, I just knew he was up to no good. I just knew he was cheating on me, bro. Like, I just knew. I just got this feeling in my heart. My heart just sunk in my body. And I was just like, oh my gosh, this cannot be happening to me. Like, after all I done done for you, bro. Like, are you, we BFFR, bro. So I finally muster up the little courage to just open the message. So I opened the message and she said, "You and your boyfriend broke up?" And me being me, if I don't even know you like that, why am I feeling volunteered to give you information on me, let alone my relationship? Because mind you, even though me and him was going through hard times, like our relationship was doing, we was having arguments, we were still together. So yeah, everybody knew because he would post me and we was together, even though he didn't post me often. But yeah, so I said, "Why, what's up?" And I replied to her and I was like, "Why, what's up?" And she was like, "Just asking because I got to tell you something." And I was like, "Just say what you got to say. Like, I don't want to play these games. I don't want to go back and forth. Like, I don't, just tell me what's tea, like, what's good. Just tell me." I never thought I would be one of them girls who would be in that position, but I was. But yeah, she sent me the screenshot and she kept asking me, is this his new girlfriend? And she was like, did you not know about her? I was like, "No, babe, that is not his new girlfriend. Me and him are still together. That is his ex. And no, we did not break up." And she was like, "Oh, shoot." Like, she was in shock. She was in shock. I was in shock, but I wasn't in shock as much as her because I already knew, like, one thing I do, I might play dumb, but I be knowing. I just like to let stuff play out. But anyway, yeah, she was in shock, and she was like, "Oh, shoot." And I was just like, "Thank you, love." And I just let it be that. So then after that, y'all, I'm just sitting in my room, and I'm just stuck for a good 10 minutes. And I'm just like, wow, like, my dreams never leave me wrong. My gut feelings never leave me wrong. My intuition always right. So then I'm like, wow, this is a corny nigga for real. Like, me and you supposed to be locked in green. You got me sending you money. You on the phone with me all the time while you at work. We constantly FaceTiming, and this is what you do to me? Really? After so much stuff that, and I'm not just saying after all the done for you for no reason. I've done so much for this boy, and he literally knows it. Speaking of that, he done hit me up the other day. But we ain't gonna talk about it. That's a whole different story. Because he knows. Like, after all I done, that's all kept going through my mind. It's like, after all I done for you, G. So, yeah, I'm just sitting there and I'm just thinking. So, for a good 20 minutes, I'm thinking, what should I do? So, I'm like, okay, at this point, me and him done, I don't even care. So, I see him the screenshot and I'm like, "You lame." And I put laughing emojis and I blocked him after that, and I did not talk to him again for like, so yeah, I blocked him after that, and I did not talk to him again for like a cool month straight at all. Because one thing I don't play about is my emotions, you feel me? Like, don't make me open and don't make me vulnerable with you if you know that your intentions is not pure, you feel me? Because one thing that I don't do is play with other people's emotions. So I expect people to give me the same effort and the same amount of respect. So I didn't talk to him for like a month straight because that was just embarrassing. You have another girl sending me screenshots, G. Like, it was so embarrassing, bro. But of course, me and him started back talking somehow. So actually, he was blocked. So what he would do was consistently reply to my stories to get my attention, and then he kept asking to take me on a date. So I was like, "Bro, just put your money where your mouth is." So he ended up playing. I said, "If that's really what you want to do, you feel me? If you really feel guilty about your actions, or you really just want to make up for what you did, set it up. You feel me? Set it up. Stop texting me and blowing me up without the real intentions or without no real actions behind it. You feel me? Because at this point, I'm out for you. So it's going to take some real step up. So he ended up setting it up and he planned the day. And he got back to me like 10 minutes later. And he was like, okay, let me take you shopping. So I'm like, okay. And I had left him my red. Then a couple of weeks later, he had asked me again. And I agreed. So he ended up setting it up. And we ended up actually going shopping at the mall. After we went shopping, he was just giving me the run around. Never really apologizing or taking accountability for what he did, bro. And I overlooked it, of course. Me having a big heart, I overlooked it. I was like, okay, people can make mistakes. Dudes can be immature. And I know that dudes can change. So that's how me and him started back talking. Because that we went out and, you feel me, we talked about it and it was what it was. Even though, like I said, he never did apologize. I just decided to not forget about it, but I decided to just let go of it and just try to start fresh with him. So we back talking, we back cool. I'm like, yeah. Okay. Stuff going good. I'm like, okay. This might work. Silly me. So, we 2 months into talking, and this specific night, me and him decided to go see a movie together. So, it's around like 8 p.m. or whatever, and my mom pull up to the movies, drop me off. He pull up to the movies, and he come in. And we just chilling for a little bit before the movie started. Then after that, we going to the movies. And y'all, my intuition never leaves me wrong. So the whole time while we there, I just have like, he just giving these weird vibes. Like he got something to hide. Like he just being sneaky. Like he just giving me this anxious feeling. Like he ready to go. Like it's something on his mind. So I'm steady asking him, is you good? Like, are you okay? And I'm just like, God, if it's something going on. So I'm just thinking, God, if it's something going on, I know you're going to reveal it. Just reveal it. Just do it for me, Lord. Just do it for me again, even though you already showed me the first time. So, y'all, we watching a movie or whatever, and towards like the end of the movie, my phone died. There wasn't nobody but God. So my phone died. So once the movie over, I asked him, can I see your phone? Because I got to text my mama. I got to let her know. Come pick me up or whatever. So he's still giving me these weird vibes. Like, are you okay? So after that, I'm like, all right. He making it obvious that it's just something going on. So I get his phone. He's standing over me, peeking from the side, trying to see what I'm doing in his phone. Mind you, I've never been the kind of girl to even go through a dude's phone. But it was just something, like, in me trying to, I just want to figure out what is the issue. Like, what is the problem? What are you hiding? Why are you doing all of this? You know what I'm saying? Like, even though you're not saying nothing or doing nothing, your energy, like, I'm a person who can feel people's energy. So I'm like, all right, let me see. So I text my mama, and then I'm like, all right, it's something going on. I need to see. So then, y'all, he's still standing over me, G. So I immediately gave him his phone back, but my mama hadn't texted back yet, so it was a cool 10 minutes, and we had went out the back door of the AMC, and we just waiting up there by where all the bricks and stuff at, and my mama finally responded. So he handed me his phone, and he like on the opposite side of me, so I'm replying to my mama, and all of a sudden, I see this message from this girl. Mind you, he has her pen, so it wasn't like I was just going through the dude's phone. So she at the top, and I see this message from this girl, and I take my mama back, and then I see the message, and she asking him, do you want to go night swimming? And then it's like a picture of her at the top, G. So I'm like, who is this? Like, who is this? You ain't never told me about no girl. Like, what? So I clicked the messages. Y'all. So I clicked the messages, G, and my heart literally dropped in my stomach, bro. It just hit the floor, bro. Like, I just wanted to steal off on this dude. So I clicked the messages. I didn't even have to scroll up. I see messages. She calling him daddy. He calling her bae. Oh, baby this. Oh, baby that. They taking pictures together. She bent all over on him. I'm like, gee, this dude gonna make me crazy. Like, I ain't never been this crazy female. And you finna bring this out of me. And I'm letting you. Like, how could I let you? How could you play me? How could you play me, baby? You did me shady. Like, I'm like, whoa. So, y'all, I couldn't help it. I slapped him so hard. I'm like, who is this, bro? Y'all, so I reached my hand back and I slapped him. Like, I applied force to it. I'm like, Green, who is this in your phone, bro? Like, not this again. Not this lame stuff again. So, he looked shocked, but at the same time, he laughing. I'm like, bro, what is funny? Like, it's so crazy how you sitting up here laughing when, like, my heart is literally dropping in my body, G. So, my mama sent the message, and she replied. She said, I'm here. So, y'all, I'm sitting up here wiping my little tears. I'm sitting up here crying. Oh, my God. Just a hot mess. And I'm walking down, I'm walking down. But whole time, I knew he didn't have no why. You feel me? He didn't have no lift. He couldn't order no lift because he didn't have no Wi-Fi on his phone. So, I'm acting like I'm finna leave him, knowing my big old heart wouldn't finna allow me to leave him. So, I'm like, bro, do you need a ride? So I walk down the stairs. Then I walk back up, and I'm like, bro, do you need a ride, bro? My mom is here. So, he's still sitting up and having this little smirk on his face. And I'm just like, bro, I made up in my mind that night that I was literally off of him. Like, it was never going to be nothing serious again. I was never finna allow him in my heart space again. You feel me? Which I shouldn't have even allowed him in my heart space that in the first place. But you live and you learn. So, I'm like, bro, come on. So, me having a good heart, me having a big heart, I told him, my mama drop you off. So, whole ride home, he just staring at me. Just staring at me. Like, what are you looking at? Look at that girl in your phone. But, yeah, so, whole ride home, he's just staring at me. And I'm just thinking to myself, bro, please get out my mama car. Please get out my mama car. Like, you lucky I didn't leave you. You lucky I didn't leave you up there at that movie theater. Like, it's always the good girls that get taken advantage of, bro, I swear. Yeah, he get out the car. He go in the house. And I get home, and I'm just numb at this point. Like, at that moment, I ain't gonna lie, that situation was the situation that made me literally put a guard around my heart permanently. Like, I've never been able to feel the kind of love that I used to be able to give and receive relationship-wise after that situation at all. I've never been able to do it. And I'm not going to. But, yeah, so he said, of course, he sent me this paragraph. Oh, I'm sorry, baby, I'm sorry. She can never take your place. You're the only one that I want. I'm just using her. You feel me? Like, I'm just playing my role to use her car. Yada, 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 yada. A whole bunch of stuff that I do not care about and I do not want to hear because it does not change the fact. He's just saying this long paragraph and just going on and on about stuff that I don't care about or want to hear because it does not change the fact that you still played in my face for the second time and the last time. And mind y'all, this girl was an ace or spade. This was a whole nother girl I had never heard of before, y'all. So, I'm just like, at this point, I thought that people could change, but it's not likely. And that's basically the take of this whole story. That's basically the end of this story time, y'all. After that scenario, after scenario number two of him just playing in my face, I'm still cool with him. I don't have no bad blood with him. But after scenario number two, I never messed with him in that way again. You feel me? I never took it to another level. And I just decided to distance myself from him for good, as I should. For my own health and my own heart. You feel me? But yeah, so that's the takeaway from this story. People can change, but it's less likely. Don't ever be the girl to try to change your dude. Do not ignore the red flags. And just allow yourself to receive everything that you deserve. Don't be so desperate and don't be so quick to hop into a relationship to where you accept anything. You accept the bare minimum. Because just like it's girls out here looking for somebody who's going to give them everything they deserve, it's dudes out here who looking for a girl who's doing the same thing. So it's not impossible to find somebody who gives you everything and more. So yeah, this story time was just a quick little insight on something that I experienced in my life. I hope y'all take away some advice from this story or y'all just enjoyed it. And like, comment, subscribe, and comment down below any other story times or video ideas y'all have for me. And I do have another video dropping soon.